Mike's try to capitalize with only 7 laps to go. Remember, that pole position also gives him the number one pit pick next week at Martinsville, the first race of the round of 8. So that, between that and the playoff points, this 78 looks like he is a contender for Miami. And then you have to just ask yourself, with Kyle Larson looking like he's not going to advance, probably one of the better drivers in Miami running around the top of the racetrack, that also bodes well for the 78. Things just continue to seem to fall in order to make the 78 your favorite for the championship here in 4 weeks.
With a mile and a half being their best racetrack, I'm not so sure that this next round lays out very well for them. But with that point advantage that they've earned throughout the year, solid days will move them forward. But it's not easy to have a solid day at Martinsville. We see how crazy it gets. Side-by-side battles the entire race. You never have a break at Martinsville. I think that's the race that this team would be worried about the most.
Martinsville, Texas, and Phoenix. The third round of the playoffs. That round of 8, where only 4 drivers advanced to the championship in Homestead, Miami. Kelly.
And Rick Culpern, crew chief on the 78, told me that Martinsville was like their wild card for the next round, but he feels like their short track program has gotten much better. He said, look, if we can get out of Martinsville with either a win or a decent finish, they feel really confident about Texas and Phoenix to get into Miami. But he said, Miami is our biggest issue. It has not been our best track. We need to get there first, but then our focus will be getting better there. And as I mentioned earlier, they will be testing at Miami 2 days coming up this next week. So that's really the focus on the 78 team.
78 team looking for another mile and a half win. They have been dominant on mile and a half racetracks. And now just 3 laps to go for Mark Trex Jr. and the whole Furniture Row Racing team. I'm sure appreciating this run that Martin Truex Jr. has put together.
Think about this, Rick. If this ends right now, this team will have an average finish on mile and a half of 2.8. Think about that. 2.8.
2.8, and only one driver in the history of NASCAR has ever had a better finish, average finish, on mile and a half tracks. It's Bobby Labonte at 2.4. Now, Martin Truex Jr. could dive down there and get that even better, because there are 2 mile-and-a-half tracks left. The Texas track, as well as Homestead, Miami. So he could get that average finish on mile-and-a-half tracks even lower than 2.8, which could be happening if he finishes up here in this number one spot. And again, we have to remember from Furniture Row Racing, passing away yesterday, Jim Watson. There's 1 lap to go, presented by Credit One Bank. One more time around the mile and a half. A fabricator for the Furniture Row team. Jim Watson lost his life yesterday. And so now, with heavy hearts, they race. But Martin Truex Jr. trying to put another win in the column for the organization and the family. Coming through 3 and 4 for the final time. He's going to do it again. Martin Truex Jr. wins.
Pretty good, champ. Love you, bud.
Again, this moment presented by Sunoco, fueling victories all season.